hard thing.
Well, we can hardly turn him out now. It wouldn't be fair.
I'm sure we have to report the man with some first.
I don't see why, Deb. Besides, didn't you say with the stowaway? Break it already.
Then there is a question of pocket money. I'm not sure how much money to give a bear.
We'll give him 20 pence a week, the same as Jonathan and Judy.
Okay, but we'll have to see what Mrs. Bird has to say about it first.
All right. Then you'd better ask her. It was your idea.
I suppose you want to tell me you decided to keep a young Paddington.
May we please, Mrs. Bird? I'm sure he'll be very good.
That remains to be seen. Different people have different ideas about being good. All the same, he looks like the sort of bear who means well.
Do you don't mind, Mrs. Bird?
No, I don't mind at all. I've always had a soft spot for bears myself. It'll be nice to have one about the house.
Well, who would have thought of it?
I expect it was because his ways did that and made a good impression. I suppose someone ought to write to his Aunt Lucy. I'm sure she'd like to know how he's getting along.
By the way, how is he getting along?
She's the one who lives in Hope Retirement. I'm over here.
I'm a horse butt.
It's in front of Mr. Wild, darkest Peru.
Wake up, Paddington.
Oh, I do believe he's asleep.
I'm not surprised. I'm sure there aren't many bears that have quite such a busy day.
Especially from...
Stacey Jones.
Judy Brown. Tiffany.
Jonathan Kelly.
Mrs. Bird. Terri Warnes.
Mr. Brown.
Wade Smith.